welcome to the latest episode of Middle-Aged Fat Ass. This week, I want to talk about why I shy away from body positive events. Now, I knew that I would have to talk about this sooner or later, but since going on my journey to health, I've had to cut out a lot of negative influences in my life, meaning people who did not want to see me better physically, mentally, or spiritually. These are the same people who think that there is nothing wrong with obesity. They think that obesity in some cases is sexy, or that obesity is healthy, and that I should just love my size, even if it shortens my life. So those were the people I just had to cut out of my life because if I wanted to advance as a human being, I couldn't have those influences in my life. Plus, another reason I shy away from these body positive events, and every time I get an event via Facebook or other social networks, I decline because as someone who was once sexualized for her obesity, I really don't want to be objectified by horny, desperate men who only see me as a fetish and not as a human being. Now, I know this sounds harsh, but it's true. It's really true. A lot of fat admirers will not see a fat woman as a person. They will see her as a fetish and not as a human being. And you know what? I think that's just wrong. Why should I go to these events if I'm only going to be objectified for my obesity? To me, this isn't okay. It brings back a lot of triggers. And this is another reason why I avoid body positive events. Someone who recently woke up at the beginning of the year and saw fat acceptance for what it really was, I kind of started meeting people who were very, very fat acceptance and very militant. It's not just in the real world either, it's in the online world. And I get really sick and tired of seeing memes just like this on Facebook.
Preaches against body policing and stereotyping based on looks, bashes anyone thinner, calls all thin women anorexic, and refuses to date fat guys. Befriend all fat women, call all thin or athletic women sluts.
And don't get me started on the other set of memes that I see floating around online, because I don't know about you, but seeing memes like this really support this hateful mindset, and they're not body positive in my opinion. So let's take a look at those.
To all girls who die for a zero figure, sweetie, remember, real men go for curves. Only dogs go for bones. A woman without curves is like jeans without pockets. You don't know where to put your hands.
Oh yes, and don't get me started on trying to intertwine feminism, which is a movement I hold near and dear to my heart, along with fat activism. Because I'm sorry, when you're over 300 pounds and you're holding up a sign that says this is what a feminist looks like, that's really insulting to my intelligence. When I was brainwashed by fat acceptance not too long ago, I will admit that I joined in with my fellow fat girls as I made fun of skinny girls. And I remember there was one night in particular where me and a bunch of my girlfriends went to this strip club. And of course, now in the strip club, you know, you have like the typical stripper look with the fake tits and the ghetto booty. But our waitress, she was built like, well, she didn't have breasts. She didn't have hips, and she didn't have an ass. And what I didn't realize what I was doing at the time, I was doing body shaming along with my fellow fat girls. We were saying hateful things about this waitress. She's a black girl. Where's her badonkadonk? Oh, wait a minute. She's built like a 12-year-old boy, you know? And when I think back on that night, I really, really feel bad. This was a young woman. She didn't deserve our hate. She didn't deserve our scorn. She didn't deserve to be made fun of. But we went ahead and we fucking did it anyway because we wanted to feel good about ourselves, especially at the time when we thought, well, we're real women because we have curves. No, curves do not make a woman. This is what happens when women hate on other women. Women bring each other down. So let me roll a clip on what happens when women start hating on each other.
Like, she's a dirty little whore.
No, I don't know what her name is. Does it matter?
So, like, I'm at the gym, and this girl walks in, and she has, like, crazy, like, ripped abs. Like, wearing a sports bra and, like, these tight little, like, workout pants. And I'm like, who do you think you are? Ew. I mean, it's not like you worked for that body, right? Does she really need to show that much cleavage? Her boobs are probably fake. There are, like, children around. Maybe you paid for your boobs, and maybe you want to show them off. Maybe they're real, and maybe you're proud of them. Maybe that makes you a skank. First day, first meeting, and she, like, just raises her hand like she, has a voice. I'm like, excuse me, like, you're just walking in there with your ideas and acting like you know things and, like, want to be, like, all taking initiative. Like, who do you think you are?
I'm just a guy's girl, you know?
Girls are such drama.
I have, like, one girlfriend, but I don't have time for that. I'm hanging out with the guys. I'm a guy's girl.
I just have so many haters.
Hashtag pretty girl problems. It's so unfair to just be hated on, you know, for, like, being so awesome.
So I hate them too. Real women have thigh gaps.
Real women are a size 16.
A size 8?
Real women are a size 0.
Real women have hips.
Real women are brunettes.
Real women are blonde.
Real women don't eat meat.
Real women are vegan.
Real women don't eat veggies.
Real women have real boobs.
Real women have big boobs.
Real women love men.
Real women love women.
Sexually.
Real women don't wear makeup.
Stop it!
Stop.
Real women don't put each other down. They lift each other up. Real women empower other women. Real women want to help. Real women don't judge each other. That makes you look bad. That makes you feel bad.
Girl-on-girl hate is all fun and games until it happens to you.
Here's the thing. 9 times out of 10, you have no idea who you're even talking about. And yet, you have enough information to call her names, put her down, and ruin her reputation for no apparent reason. Does it really make you feel better?
Stop girl-on-girl hate and start lifting each other up.
Because girls are awesome!
Well, I hope that was a little educational. Now, since losing weight and trying to be healthy, I have actually been trying to be very careful about how I not only treat myself, but how I treat others. When I see body hate of either fat people or skinny people, I think it's disgusting now. Because what fat acceptance needs to realize is that all bodies are beautiful. It's not just one body type. Because once we realize that it's not all about one body type, we can finally move forward with body positivity. That's my personal opinion on the matter. If I were invited to a body positive event, I would still shy away. And here's one of the reasons I would actually kind of shy away. With the militant attitudes of fat acceptance, I would feel like a minority walking into a Klan meeting.
Hey boys, look what I got here.
Hey, where are the white women at?
Man, that was pretty. I like that.
Qualifications?
Stampeding cattle.
That's not much of a crime.
Through the Vatican?
Kinky. Sign here.
Oh. Why, rat, how many times have I told you to wash up after weekly cross burning? See, it's coming off.
Oh. And now for my next impression, Jesse Owens.
Seize them!
And this is one of the reasons why you will never see me at a body positive event. But hey guys, if we want true body positivity and we want to stop the hostility between fat people and thin people, maybe we need to stop this little bullshit saying right here.
Real women have curves.
If this much hate can be spewed online, who's to say this much hate can't be spewed in real life right to your face just because of how you look? Personally, I think it's bullshit, especially with women. I mean, come on, ladies. Instead of tearing each other down, let's build each other up. So, when you start skinny shaming that girl in front of you, or when you start fat shaming the other girl in front of you, think about this. Feminism was not founded on narcissism. And if we're going to have a woman in the White House, maybe we need to start dropping our narcissistic bullshit, don't you think? On to my progress this week. This week, I did not drop a pound. As a matter of fact, I am still holding steady at 178. I am still doing my regular routine at Planet Fitness of 3 days of cardio, 3 days of strength training, and it's so far working good. With this 90 plus degree weather we've been having this week, I have been really sweating my ass off. And that's also been a good thing. It's also opening up the pores, getting all the toxins out. And on my blog, I give at least 2 weeks worth of my routine. For some of you out there, it could be a really strenuous routine. So I say don't exactly follow it to the letter. I'm just sharing what works for me. And if it works for you, cool. If it doesn't, step back, take a breather, relax, because, I mean, I'm not going to expect everybody to do what I do. I've been doing this for a couple of months, and if you're new to physical fitness, I would strongly suggest taking it easy for the first few times so you're not killing yourself. And also, when you're working out or you're jogging or whatever or doing Tai Chi, drink lots of water. Your body will thank you later on for that. And now, I want to tell you a little bit about my comedy channel. Every Saturday at noon until the end of August, I am doing a little mini-series called Things on the Internet That Make You Go, What the Fuck? This is a little mini-series where I take videos off the internet and I kind of scrutinize them a little bit, kind of criticize them just a little bit, and kind of make fun of them. But it's all in good fun. This week, we're going to be catching a few people on surveillance doing things that they shouldn't do. So stay tuned for that. And that's going to happen every Saturday at noon until the end of August. Well, I'm signing off. I will see you guys next week. Be sure to stay healthy and stay beautiful. And I will see you next time on Middle-Aged Fat Ass.